I found nothing wrong with that. Basta compatible sila. So, and also, we were informed that this has been the convergence point of a number of flocks of birds and other animals. So that means this is the point where they are. And the animals, the birds particularly, would not be staying here for long if the habitat is not improving. Because animals are highly mobile. They will stay in an area for as long as they have the shelter and for as long as they have the food. So I understand that they have the food here, they have the shelter, so they will be here. But please take note that if more additional infrastructure projects will be introduced here, the situation might change. The birds which have been migrating here, the birds which have obtained their passport and visa to stay forever in this area might be planning to leave the area, and the birds that will remain will be this one that is flying over us, the airplanes. So, ganun po, yun ano. And we would like to emphasize that environmental conservation, management, and protection is not a monopoly of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. By law, it only happened that we are mandated to take the lead in all these activities. The DNR, for sure, and we tonight do not deny that although we have this sincere and dedicated public servants, our manpower complement is not enough to safeguard the whole jurisdiction of the National Capital Region. Imagine, we are in charge of taking the lead in environmental management in 16 cities and one municipality. And I am glad that when I came to DNR, National Capital Region, just last month, I'm just a month old in the National Capital Region, I came to realize that there is only one municipality that is left as a municipality, and that is Pateros. So, had I not been given the chance to work with you in the National Capital Region, I would not have in my mind that part of geography, that Metro Manila, or the National Capital Region, is composed of 16 cities and one municipality. And how do we know? Maybe years from now, Pateros will become also a city. So, we'll be managing 17 cities. So, ganun po yun. So, this will be managed as a critical habitat and at the same time, an ecotourism area. And based on records of our staff, since 2007, after we have improved this with your support, with the support of everybody, we have in our register some 3,000 local and foreign tourists coming here annually. Hindi pa tayo kasama doon. And I would like to inform you that DNR has so many plans as far as this project is concerned. It'll be constructing very soon the visitor center, but yet still there are so many activities we have to undertake. As pointed out by our project staff, we would be conducting studies to determine the carrying capacity of this area. That is to ensure that everything will be managed on a sustainable basis. So, well, this is just part of the activities of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources in the National Capital Region. And we would be proud to announce to the whole world that with the concerted effort, with everybody's participation, we would be able to make this the most beautiful critical habitat in the entire country, if not in the entire world. Because I was informed also by our partners that so far for the year, this is adjudged to be the second second just to Iran, because that judgment is based on voting. Our prejudice that might be discussing to you in details how we can all participate so we can overturn Iran as the first placer. So let us work together to make this Lepapachia, Lepipichia, Las Piñas Paranaque critical habitat and ecosystem area as the best in the entire world. We have so many which are already in the Guinness Book of World Record. We have the Palawan, Subterranean River, we have begun the Locosor, and now we have this Lepipichia. So I'm glad that there are so many volunteers coming in. And we are happy that while there are volunteer animals, there are volunteer plants, there are so many volunteer ladies and gentlemen in this project. And I was touched by the song. Sino ba yung kumanta kanina? Kabataan. O walang ano? Walang ipin. Walang buntot. Nagpupugay sa Diyos. Yun ay para ba sinasabi na sila ay hayop lamang, samantalang tayo ang hayop na may pinakamataan taas na antas ng talino, yan ay hamon po sa ating lahat. So maraming salamat doon sa kumanta ng awiting iyan. Ipamahagi natin niya sa buong kapuluan sapagkat maantig natin ang damdamin ng bawat Pilipino sa inyong hinabing awitin. Sa ngalan po ng Department of Environment and Natural Resources, under the leadership of Secretary Ramon J. Pipahe, and of course, specifically as far as the National Capital Region of our department is concerned, Forester Lodi Wagan as the Regional Director, and of course, yours truly as the newly designated Assistant Regional Director of the DNR National Capital Region for Technical Services, we wish you all good luck. May you all have 100 century more of lives to stay and reclaim this Lepipichia project. Magandang umaga po sa inyo.
Thank you po, sir, for that very informative and inspiring words for all of us. May we now call on Mr. Norman Raquel, our Outreach Ministry Chairperson of the Central United Methodist Church.
Good morning po. Kayo ba ay natikman nyo yung dagat? Hindi? Talo ko kayo. Natikman ko kanina. Natalsikan ako. Buti na lang mahaba yung aking damit, no? Anyway, may antibiotics ba? Meron nung isang Indian principle, no? Regarding life. At ang kanilang paninindigan, principle, is they take care of their environment, the forest, the trees, the land, the animals, the water, and so on and so forth, so that 7 generations after them, it's not just their children or their children's children, but 7 generations after them will still benefit from the environment that they have and will be able to sustain the life of 7 generations after them. That's an Indian principle. At gusto ko rin i-share sa inyo, no? Meron ding social principle ang United Methodist Church. Para sa mga hindi nakakaalam, even sa mga Methodista. At isa yun, part doon, napakaliit na portion doon, has something to do with the protection of our environment as well. Specifically water, air, soil, minerals, and plants. It says, just a single paragraph, no? We support and encourage social policies that serve to reduce and control the creation of industrial byproducts and waste, facilitate the waste processing and disposal of toxic and nuclear waste, and move toward the elimination of both. Encourage reduction of municipal waste, provide for appropriate recycling and disposal of municipal waste, and assist the cleanup of polluted air, water, and soil. We call for the preservation of old growth forests and other irreplaceable natural treasures, as well as preservation of endangered plant species. We support measures designed to maintain and restore natural ecosystems. Alam niyo po, ang Central United Methodist Church, ang simbahan po namin, isa sa mga local churches, eh nagse-celebrate din ng 116th year of anniversary in Manila, no? So kung bibilangin niyo po, kung 25 years ang bawat isang generation, yung mga 16 years old and below, nasa 5th generation kayo, no? So wala pa kayo sa 7th generation. Do you think our forefathers have done a good job in preserving the environment?